In this tutorial, we'll be discussing about point effector 2D. So let's look at it with an example. In this example, I have a black hole type of an object and a planet. This black hole has a rigid body 2D attached to it and a circle collider 2D. The black hole has the gravity scale set to 0. That means it won't fall down. To this black hole, I'll attach a component, point effector 2D. So immediately you get a warning that it won't function if you don't tick the use by effector checkbox. So this suggests me to check this use by effector checkbox. This point effector 2D works more efficiently when the ease trigger property is checked. This is because it requires that the colliders overlap with each other. Now if you look at this Earth or the planet, it too has a rigid body attached and a circle collider 2D. Its gravity scale has been set to 0. Let's go back to the black hole. I'll increase the radius of it so that it covers the entire screen. So I have increased the radius of this black hole in such a way that it covers our planet. So now let's look at the properties of the point effector 2D. I'll first save this and run it and show you what happens. So you can see the planet gets attracted to the center point of this black hole, overshoots and comes back again. So what the point effector basically does, it attracts any game object or it repels any game object. The first thing we look at here is that I don't want this planet to overshoot. So what I can do in this case is that I can change the drag property in the damping one and I'll set it to a 9. Let's run it again. You'll see that the planet comes right inside this black hole, or the black hole sucks in the planet. Okay, so let's look at the properties. The first property that we look at here is the force property. Now inside force there is the force magnitude. If you want the other objects to attract to this game object, then you have to set a negative value. And if you want them to repel from this game object, then you have to set a positive value. Currently I set it to a negative 10, hence it was attracting this planet. If I set this to say around 10, I'll just zoom out a little bit, you will see it flying off from the collider. So you can see that it has started repelling from this black hole. Now the next property that we look at here is the collider mask. So if you don't tick this collider mask, this black hole will interact with all layers. Now if you untick this collider mask, then this black hole will work according to the global collision matrix. But if you tick it, you will see a drop down in the collider mask property. Here you can set the layers with which this black hole can interact with. So currently it's interacting with all the layers. I have defined a top one layer. I have created a box game object. I'll make it visible. This box game object is in the top one layer. Let's set back the force to negative 10. That is, I want them to attract. I'll disable this planet for a moment and I'll run it. So we'll see that the black hole interacts with the top one layer, or the layer in which the box was present. Now what I'll do is, I'll go to the black hole, I'll select the drop down and I'll untick this top one property. Now if I run it, you will see that it doesn't interact with the top one layer. So this is what the use collider mask and collider mask property do. I'll set this back to everything. I'll enable the planet once again and disable the box. Now the next property is the force variation. The force variation is a variation in the magnitude of the force that is applied on this planet. So to understand this, I'll set the force magnitude to 10. I'll run it once again. You'll see that it repels. But if I add a force variation of 10, the force that is applied to this planet will vary from between 10 and 20. That is the force that you had set in the magnitude field plus the value that you had set in the force variation field. So it sums up to 20. So the minimum force applied on the planet will be 10 and the maximum force applied will be 20. Now before understanding discrete scale, we'll look at all these three properties. The first is this force source. The force source has two properties. One is rigid body and the next is collider. The force source is the point on this black hole that this planet gets attracted to. If I set it to collider, then the planet will get attracted to the center of the collider. Let's make it a negative 10 and set this back to 0. Let's run it. So it comes to the center of this big collider. The way how you understand this is, if I offset this y value, you'll see that the black hole stays where it is. The planet has come to the point where the collider has moved. On the contrary, if I set it to rigid body, even if I move the collider, the attraction will happen between the planet and the black hole. So if I run it again, and if I change the offset value, you will see that the planet still sticks with the black hole. And the next property is the force target. The force target is similar to the force source, but the only difference is that the force target is a point on the planet that gets attracted to the black hole. So currently it's set to rigid body. If you set it to collider, then the attraction will happen between the center point of the collider of the planet and this black hole. And in such cases, it may happen that the planet may rotate or the game object may rotate while it gets closer to the other object. But if you set it to a rigid body, then the force of attraction will be between the rigid body's center point or the center of mass and the black hole. And at that moment, there won't be any rotation. The next property is the force mode. The force mode has three properties, that is constant, inverse linear and inverse squared. So currently I set it to inverse linear. So the force mode is how the force is applied between the two game objects. Inverse linear means that at first the attraction will happen slow, or the object will move slowly towards source, but as it gets closer to the source, its speed increases. Let's see that in action. So here you see that it starts off slowly and as it approaches, its speed increases. So this is how the force is applied between the two objects when the force mode is set to inverse linear. If I set it to constant, then the speed of the planet will be constant from beginning to the end. Let's see that in action. So here you see that it's moving with a constant force. And the final property of it is the inverse squared. In inverse squared, the inverse squared basically works according to the Newton's law of physics. So Newton's law states that the gravity between the two objects is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. That's how in the real world the gravity works. So in this case, if I run, the planet will start off much more slowly as compared to when it was set to inverse linear, and as it approaches the black hole, its speed will increase tremendously. So if I start it, you will see that it starts off very slow. And then as it approaches, its speed just multiplies. So these are the three properties of the force mode. Now next we've come to distance scale. I'll change this to inverse linear. Distance scale allows us to scale the physics simulation without scaling the game objects in the scene. That is, if I want to give others the impression that my objects are moving over greater distances, then what I can do is I can increase the distance scale value. Suppose I increase it to 10 and I have kept the force mode to inverse linear. You will see that it gives an impression that it has to travel a lot of distance before reaching to its destination. So the more the value you set in the distance scale, the more it will give you the impression that the distance it has to travel is more. On the contrary, if you set it to a less value, then it will give you an impression that the distance between them is not so much and it's moving over a short distance. The final property is the drag and the angular drag. Now the drag is basically the linear drag, that is how much force is applied on the game object in order to stop its linear movement. And the angular drag is the force applied on the object in order to stop its rotation. So currently our planet is not rotating. If you want that any rotating object slows down its rotation, then you can change this angular drag property. So I hope you understood about this point effector 2D.
Make sure to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon so you get notified of the new video that I post here on YouTube. Thank you for watching.